Welcome to Coyote Point's tutorial on how to configure an equalizer for failover to ensure 100% uptime of your mission-critical applications. In this tutorial, we'll demonstrate a six-step process for configuring two Coyote Point Equalizer E450GX application delivery controllers into an active-passive type failover configuration. In this configuration, if an equalizer should fail, the other unit will automatically engage with no interruption to the end-user experience. Before we begin, let's review the basics of server load balancing. Load balancing improves the scalability of applications by distributing the load across multiple servers. Load balancing also offers what is called high availability. This means that if one of your servers becomes unavailable, load balancing will route the traffic load across the remaining servers. An equalizer such as the E450GX model shown is a load balancer that distributes traffic among server resources. Based on information in the IP packets or content in application requests, it makes intelligent decisions to direct the traffic appropriately. Equalizers communicate with clients via a cluster on a VLAN and with servers via another VLAN. You might ask, what would happen if for some reason the load balancer stops working? Clients and servers would no longer be able to communicate with one another, and people would think your site was down. That's an undesirable situation, to say the least. That's where active-passive or active-standby failover comes in. An active-passive failover configuration includes two equalizers. One processes traffic while the other remains in standby mode and becomes active in the event of a failure. Coyote Point also supports a more complex active-active mode, but this presentation focuses on active-passive. When two equalizers are configured in failover, all of the load balancing configuration on the primary equalizer is synchronized with the backup equalizer. The standby or passive equalizer does not respond to any requests. The active unit instantiates the IP addresses of the servers to be load balanced and responds to ARP queries. Both units continually send heartbeat probes to one another. If the current primary does not respond to heartbeat probes, a failover occurs and traffic will be load balanced by the backup equalizer. The administrator makes the decision of which equalizer should be primary and which should be backup by default. The purpose of this tutorial is to show and describe the configuration of both equalizers in an active-passive failover configuration. A few words about terminology before we continue. The two equalizers configured into failover form what is called a failover pair. An equalizer in a failover pair is called a peer. The floating IP addresses are used to provide redundancy in a failover configuration. One machine is able to take over the IP address of the other and respond to ARP requests. It's simple to configure a pair of equalizers for active-passive failover. Let's review the steps. The first step is to verify that the subnets on the VLANs on the primary and backup equalizer are identical. We'll record the backup equalizer peer signature. More on that later. We'll define a backup peer on the primary equalizer. We'll also record the peer signature of the primary equalizer and define a backup peer on the primary equalizer. Finally, we'll verify that both units are heartbeating and that our configuration was a success. Let's get started with our configuration. We'll point our web browser to the backup equalizer and log into the administrative interface, also known as the GUI. Let's begin with step one. We'll verify that the subnets on the VLANs on the backup equalizer and the primary equalizers are identical. I'll click VLANs on the navigational tree on the left side of the GUI. And select the VLAN used to communicate with our network clients and click on the appropriate subnet. The Failover tab on the right pane of the GUI is where we define active-passive failover parameters. Enter a failover IP address for this subnet in the appropriate space if one has not already been configured. The failover IP has two purposes. First, it can be used as the floating gateway IP address for the servers behind the equalizer. Secondly, it provides easy GUI and SSH access to the equalizer that is in the primary mode. Now, we'll enable failover on the subnet. When checked, this will allow heartbeat probes to be sent over the subnet to the primary equalizer. Then, click on the Commit button to save our changes. Now let's do the same thing for the server VLAN. This time I'll use the external IP address in the space provided. We'll point the web browser to the primary equalizer. Select the VLAN used to communicate with our network clients and click on the appropriate subnet. I'll click on the VLAN used to communicate with the servers on the left navigational tree and select the subnet. Then, click on the Failover tab. I'm entering a failover or floating IP address for this subnet in the appropriate space if one has not already been configured. This time, I'll use the external IP address in the space provided. Click on the Commit button to save our changes. Now for step 2. We'll need to record the backup equalizer peer signature. We'll point the web browser to the backup equalizer. I'll click on Peers on the left navigational tree and select the peer on the tree. This is the backup peer. A peer signature is a long string that uses numerals and letters that uniquely identifies an equalizer. I'm copying the signature to the clipboard. We'll need to use it when we tell the primary equalizer to pair with this backup system. While we're still in the peer definition screen, let's check the configuration transfer option. This is used on the local equalizer and not on the remote equalizer. If it is enabled, the primary peers on both systems will synchronize the configuration. When it is changed for the local peer, it should be reflected in the remote peer on the other system. Let's also check the failover option. Now that we've got the signature of the backup peer, let's proceed with step 3. We're going to create a backup peer definition on the primary equalizer. We'll also add some failover flags to the new peer as well as to the peer definition for the primary equalizer, which exists already. We'll point the web browser to the primary equalizer. You may need to log in again at this point. Let's click on Peers on the left navigational tree. Now we'll right-click and select Add Failover Peer. I'll enter a name for the backup peer. I'm not feeling too creative today, so I'll name it Backup. Now let's find the peer signature that we previously saved from our backup equalizer and paste it into the signature field on this form. I'll click on the Commit button to save the new peer definition. Let's configure the new peer with failover flags. We'll select the backup peer from the left navigational tree. Let's check the failover option to enable failover on this peer. I'll click on the Commit button to save our changes. While still accessing the primary equalizer, let's go to step 4. We're going to record the peer signature of the primary equalizer. We're also going to configure some failover flags. We'll select the primary peer from the left navigational tree. Let's record the peer signature of the primary equalizer since we will use it to create a new peer definition for the primary equalizer on the backup. I'll check the failover and preferred primary options, which both enable failover and designate this equalizer as the primary equalizer in the configuration. We'll also enable the configuration transfer option. This is used on the local equalizer and not on the remote equalizer. If it's enabled, the primary peers on both systems will synchronize the configuration. When it is changed for the local peer, it should be reflected in the remote peer on the other system. Click on the Commit button to save our changes. Now we'll point the web browser to the backup equalizer, and we'll perform a similar set of operations as when we created a peer definition on the primary equalizer. We'll paste the peer signature that we copied from our primary equalizer into the signature field on this form. Now we'll enable failover on the primary peer definition on the backup equalizer. Now that we've finished configuring our primary and backup equalizers, let's proceed with step 6 and verify the configuration. Let's view the configurations of both the primary and backup equalizers to verify that no errors occurred in the configuration and that the two equalizers are heartbeating. We'll check the primary equalizer first. I'll point the web browser to the primary equalizer. Now I'll click on Peers on the left navigational tree and then select the Peer Summary tab on the right pane. Note that the equalizer that we designated as the preferred primary will indicate local with the failover options that we configured as failover and preferred primary. We're looking for the word no in the error column, and that's what we have. Now let's click on the subnet status tab to take a look at the subnets to see if the primary and backup equalizers are communicating with one another on the subnets. Both the internal and external VLANs are heartbeating. Both units continually send heartbeat probes to one another on each subnet. If the current primary doesn't respond to heartbeat probes, a failover takes place and the backup assumes the load balancing functions. Now we'll point the web browser to the backup equalizer to check if it's configured correctly and is heartbeating. I'll check the peer summary table and note that the equalizer that we designated as the backup indicates that it is local with the failover options that we configured for failover and preferred primary. Again, we'll make sure that no appears in the error column. So let's summarize what we did. We installed two Coyote Point Equalizer E450GX units and designated one as the primary and the other as the backup. We configured the two equalizers with identical VLAN failover configurations and assigned a common failover IP address. We've created peer definitions on each equalizer and enabled failover options. And the equalizers will now continually check the health of each other through heartbeat probes. When the backup determines that heartbeat probes have stopped, it takes over as the active equalizer and processes all requests. As you can see, when heartbeating stops on the primary equalizer, it fails over to the backup, which now becomes the primary. In this video, we showed you the basics of setting up an active-passive failover configuration that will work with any matched pair of Coyote Point equalizers. If you need more information on failover configurations or other advanced features, please visit the support section of our website at coyotepoint.com. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you need the latest in application delivery features with unparalleled ease of use, be sure to check back with us for new products, updates, and helpful tips at coyotepoint.com.